Wings send it in deep with less than four to go in the period, and they'll whistle it down as one of the Detroit players is on the ice and has been injured. And that is Brenden Perlini, I think.
Yeah, we'll take a look at this collision right here. We're going to take a look what happened to Brenden Perlini. They are helping him off the ice during the timeout. Trainers got over there to help him. You see the towel on his face. We're going to show you exactly what happened. He's going to get clipped with a skate. Watch this right here, the follow through. Oh. Joki Haru's skate's going to take him right on the right side of the face. And it does not look good.
No, but it didn't look as bad as I thought it was when I first saw it. Now, it's easy for me to say because I couldn't tell exactly how much damage was done, but.
Now, that's those cases right there, just total accidents, and it's unfortunate, but. You just hope that he's all right and there's no major damage.
And they have to clean up the blood that's on the ice at the point of the.
Probably pretty much had that one counted in the win column. The Islanders came storming back. One of the toughest losses of the year for the Flyers. Niskanen fires that one wide. And play is stopped as an Islander is down and in some discomfort. It's Casey Cizikas. The referee blue play dead immediately, and Cizikas right off the ice. That does not look good.
Let's take a look and see what happened there. Cizikas going for the loose puck, gets tripped up. Does he get cut by a skate? Boy, that's weird, isn't it? Was in a lot of discomfort immediately as he went down. I can take another look at the Cizikas injury here as he gets twisted up and goes down, and you can see he is in immediate discomfort and was able to look up at the referee and at least communicate to him that he was not doing well. And that's when the referee blew the whistle.